Hi everyone, my name is Aarti Narayanan, Head of Administration at ABS Marine Services Private Limited, a ship owning and ship management company. Joining me today is none other than Mr. Amar Singh Thakur, General Secretary, the Maritime Union of India, representing Merchant Navy officers. This is a person who needs no introduction, but is constantly at the forefront of seafarer welfare. Good afternoon, sir, and welcome to the Maritime CEO.
Good afternoon, Aarti. Namaskar.
I'd like to begin with asking you various initiatives of the MUI to support women seafarers.
Yeah, well, Aarti, first of all, I will thank you for giving me this opportunity, this platform. So you have asked me for the what are the initiative MUI to support for the women seafarer. Well, MUI has always stood for the women empowerment and acknowledge the contribution. Over the decades, women have chosen to take up the seafarer career at sea. In India, we have a growing number of women seafarers. MUI Women Wing was conceived to cater women from maritime community, including women seafarer. And Mrs. Saleha Sheikh is the head of the coordinator for the MUI Women Wing. And she works very closely with the women seafarer. See, we have created a special cell for the women seafarer that is called Dignity at Sea. Okay. And where all kinds of problems faced by the women seafarer are discussed and addressed. The cell, which coordinates with the DG Shipping and companies whenever it is required to address grievances of the women seafarer, and can call and speak with our teams, with the women being, discuss any problem on board they are facing. And with their experience, they can share. We actively support the education of the women seafarer by subsidizing their educational fees at maritime training institutes. And the Women Wing organizes education and initiative workshop from time to time to empower women in maritime sector. That's all.
That's nice to know the many initiatives that you've taken up for women. Do you see any significant increase in the recruitment of women seafarers in the next 5 years?
Yes, of course, we are very positive that the number of women seafarers are going up and increasing significantly in the coming years. And in coordination with the DG Shipping and various shipping companies, we have taken measures and steps to ensure increase in recruitment of women seafarers. Our Women Wing has been very active towards the bringing about much awareness, various campaigning as well, with the efforts of that are being made. And we are positive that number of women seafarers being recruited will only increase. However, we have to keep working on it. But that one has to do also, because nowadays, you know, this is a male-dominated industry.
Yes.
We have to work on it. And we have to force the shipping company to induct the more women seafarers. So we are working on it.
Yes, that is true, but there is a positive sign, and that's nice to know. Has MUI been able to cater to the change in the group dynamics now that we engage more women seafarers on board? Has there been any change in the group dynamics on board?
This is a subject that requires team efforts. It's a very difficult subject, and it requires the efforts by all stakeholders and shipping industry. In coordination with the DG Shipping, and we have to deliberate on how to improve group dynamic onboard ship through various campaign and workshop, and through our empowerment of women in maritime initiative. We have been holding various program intent to sensitize seafarers on working alongside with the women seafarers. And definitely positive, we are going to.
That's very nice to know, sir, that the various initiatives are being taken up. I understand that it's a team effort and all stakeholders need to be part of it. And I'm very happy that you are initiating all of these things. Can you tell us more about the Women's Wing incepted by MUI? Any special features that it has?
Yes, Aarti, because, initially concept, we created this platform And when I came to know that there was one late chief engineer wife approached MUI instead of penny. So she was receiving a lot of notices from the income tax department, even after demise or harassment. So she did not know where to go and what was to be done, since she had lost her husband. So MUI then took up these challenges, and immediate steps were taken to create a platform and address such issues. So the woman we were finally inserted in 2017 with the help of Ms. Celia Sheikh, and we have core team member team, four member team, which includes Mrs. Lata Khatri, Ms. Puru, Ukaji, and Ms. Ilam Mamal. For MUI, the welfare of seafarer have always been the priority. However, the woman being not only catered to the woman seafarer, but also to families of the seafarers, suffering depression, loneliness, as well confidential medical advice can be sought through our helpline. Under our welfare scheme, we organize skill building workshop and education seminar and various topics which are addressed by experts. Our woman being also organized competition from time to time, and seafarers are their families. We also organize workshop on mental and physical well-being.
Right, that's very understanding, because for a seafarer, stability, mental stability on board, the family is very important, and to look after the family is the biggest initiative that you have taken up, and that's very nice of you.
Yeah, and art, and we are doing art and relationship personal management. Another very interesting part of the woman being is the event in personality of the month, which is an MUI woman being especially they created, where we facilitate one lady member for the extraordinary work towards self and society.
That's lovely to know. And I'm sure all the families are also taking part in all your events and basically bringing the community together and ensuring that the seafarer is well taken care of, both ashore as well as on board.
Yeah. So during this pandemic, the woman wing was very actively connected with the families of seafarer. Our head coordinator, Saleha, was constant touch with the woman seafarer on board ship, checking on their well-being first constantly, and many seafarer family were facing some or other problem during the lockdown period. So we have various chapters throughout India, so throughout network, and these human beings were able to help seafarer and their families in solving their problems. And many seafarer wives were expecting, and their seafarer were stuck on board ship due to crew change problem, their delays. Mm-hmm. Human being was constantly touched these ladies and offered some kind of sport. So though the woman being Zoom, even they had Zoom session on mental health and well-being.
Okay.
So at the end, we have 24/7 helpline. So they are counseling many members of the families, as well as helpline numbers. We are given that 843-388-4890. So you can note on that number also.
Yes, we will definitely do that. And thank you for having a dedicated line for the families of these seafarers. Any other welfare measures that you would like to highlight?
Yeah, we have during this COVID period also, we have supplied oxygen cylinder masks various locations in India during the peak time of pandemic. And we have also petitioned to the Chief Minister of Maharashtra, Goa, Bihar, even Punjab, and even Ministry of Shipping for the vaccines of seafarer on priority basis for our age groups, since they need to join the ship, foreign port, and also in Indian ports. And we are also looking forward to establishing licensing office in Dehradun and Lucknow, and convince of the seafarers for the both sites, city. And MUI is in process launching a mentoring cell called Disha. So the intention is to guide the seafarer in their career and also to help them in their transition from ship to shore. So we are going to launch a mentoring cell. So that is called Disha. So at Entrepreneur Directory will be published in November 2021. This will include details of women entrepreneurs from the maritime community who have started a new business or venture. Through this directory, we wish to empower women in maritime and also have a healthy exchange of business within the maritime community.
That's a lovely initiative, sir. Soft skills and business skills are very important in for today's women and for the seafarers. And that's something very different that you have brought out this morning. We now come to the end of this session. Thank you, sir, for enlightening us on the various activities of the Maritime Union of India. And thank you for taking our time and being a part of the Maritime CEO Conference. A big thank you to the audience for listening in. This is Aarti signing off. Goodbye.
Thank you very much, Aarti. Thank you.